As part of its continuing commitment to humorless programming, National Public Radio presents That's Not Funny with your host, Skylar Umbridge.
Hi, I'm Skylar Umbridge. Welcome to That's Not Funny. My first guest is Fred Donahue, and he certainly has a unique profession.
Yes, I am a food tester. I test food for zaniness. For the sake of consumers, I determine if certain food products are as wacky as they claim to be.
That's very interesting. And you're going to do a live demonstration for us.
Yes, I have here a jar of Fluffernutter marshmallow spread.
That sure sounds like a wacky product.
Yes, it does. I will taste it now. Well, I'm only sensing a medium level of whimsy. It's lacking the robust irreverence of the 83 Nutter Butter Peanut Butter Sandwich Cookie.
That is valuable consumer information.
Yes, and now I am going to taste test a Nutrageous bar. Well, I must say, the nutrageousness is really coming through quite distinctly.
Excuse me, but I'm willing to put up with nuttiness. I'm willing to put up with outrageousness, but there's no place for nutrageousness in this studio. That's not funny! Get out! Get out! My next guest on That's Not Funny is Clarence Lewis, who is a singer-songwriter with a politically satirical bent.
Yes, I sing satirical songs that poke fun at the foibles and follies of American political life. Here's a piece I wrote that skewers the Republican presidential field. Everybody's tuning in to see the candidates in the GOP. The primary season is about to begin. I really wonder who's gonna win. Because I do, I wonder.
That's it. That's the whole song.
Yeah, you can see the wonder in my face. You know, we really don't know who's going to win the race, do we?
Yeah, I guess.
I'm not afraid to speak truth to power. I'm sorry if I ruffled some feathers with that one. Here's a song I wrote that takes on the whole Herman Cain thing.
Well, that is certainly a ripe area for satire. Go ahead.
Herman Cain has certainly amassed charges for women who say they were harassed. Many are saying he should be axed, but I don't like to pass judgment until I've seen all the facts.
So, your satirical take on Herman Cain is,
Well, that it would be irresponsible for me to offer an opinion about his situation one way or the other at this point.
And yet you wrote a song about it.
Of course, as a satirist, I couldn't resist the Herman Cain story. And if you'll please indulge me, I'd like to perform my musical takedown of the Koch brothers.
Oh, the Koch brothers. Yes, absolutely.
I should warn you, I'm taking no prisoners with this one.
Please go ahead.
The Koch brothers are behind the scenes of one of the biggest political machines. There's much to be said about all their dealings, but I won't say it because it might hurt their feelings.
Wow, you're very considerate of the political targets you take on.
Yes, as a political satirist, I believe that if you don't have anything nice to say, just don't say it.
I thought you said you were taking no prisoners.
Well, there wasn't a single reference to taking prisoners in that song. It wasn't even about prison or prisoners, so I clearly delivered on my promise.
I have to say, for a political satirist, you're a bit odd.
Well, I'm sorry if my songs are a little too edgy for you, Skylar Umbridge. You usually kick people off your show, but I'm gonna beat you to it. I'm outta here.
That was awkward. And speaking of awkward, my next guest on That's Not Funny was visiting me for Thanksgiving, and I thought I'd have him on so he could finally see for himself what I do for a living. Please welcome my dad, Tyler Umbridge. Welcome, Dad.
Boy, you're not exactly Cokie Roberts, are you?
Dad.
Yep, your mother and I had high hopes for you. Just imagine how happy we were when you changed your major at school from law to liberal arts.
Dad, please.
Who wants a daughter on the Supreme Court when she can be the host of a show that airs in the middle of the afternoon on a station that has fewer listeners than a ham radio?
Dad, we went over all this at Thanksgiving.
Ladies and gentlemen, since this is NPR, I should point out that Skylar Umbridge's college education was made possible by a grant from the Skylar's Parents Flushing Money Down the Toilet Foundation.
Dad, please, let's not rehash all this.
I wanted a son. I always wanted a son. But after your birth, your mother stopped sleeping with me.
Dad, why are you bringing all this up on the air? This is private stuff.
What could be more private than your radio show?
That's not funny.
No, there's nothing funny about living to be my age and looking back on a life filled with nothing but disappointment.
Well, folks, now you have some insight as to where I got my humorlessness from. Thank you for joining us on That's Not Funny.
What? What did I say?
That's not funny, Dad.
Come on, honey, man up.
It's really not
funny. Grow a pair.
Can you just get out, please?